I think if you cut out a lot of the negativity around you, and some of it you don't even realize is being negative, you cut that stuff out, it gets way easier to increase your emotional capacity, to let go of those trades and to detach, to almost become more enlightened as a trader. But you have to cut out the negativity, which means friends, family, the content that you're watching, like stop watching Lost, as Gary Vee would say, right? Like your people waste their time and they get caught up in, yeah, Lost, in my opinion, sometimes those TV shows, they're negative. You know what I mean? They're wasting your time that you say you want to be growing and going forward and driving the ship, like I said, but you're wasting your time. So I think if you cut out a lot of the negativity, and I want to talk to you about how you've done that personally, but I think if you do that, don't you agree? You can definitely then increase emotional capacity, definitely control the emotions more because you're not being influenced by as many people. You have self-confidence and that kind of comes out in your trading.
Yeah, 100%. I agree, and I feel like that's how I like to say I'm pretty good when it comes to handling my emotions, when it comes to trading, and that does tie into the fact that I've learned from a very young age to cut out negativity from my life. Everybody in my family knows that no matter what, I'm the kind of guy who's gonna do what he wants to do, regardless of what
Sure.
anybody thinks.
You're that
Literally,
guy.
regardless, I'm that guy. Yeah, I'm that guy in my family who has started and failed at multiple businesses, who is pretty much a jack of all trades to the point where I know a lot about everything like graphics, computers, web designing. And that's all stuff that I learned. And like even trading, I kind of just picked it up out of nowhere and now I'm trading, right? So I've learned from a very young age to kind of not really care about what anybody says. And even keeping like my personal life and my personal endeavors just to myself and, maybe my wife pretty much, because she's the one that supports me 100%. Not saying
Is
that
that
my
because you
family
know everything
doesn't.
else is not going to understand? Is that really why?
Yes, that's pretty much it for me. I
Because you're
mean,
like,
and I
listen, I'm
don't
not going to convince you. You're not
exactly.
going to get it. I'm not going to even waste my energy then. I'm the same way.
That's exactly how I think. Like, I don't expect you to get it, and if you don't get it, that's okay with me. We don't have to agree because everybody has their own opinions, but I'm doing what I want to do because that's just what I want to do. If you don't agree with it, then that's okay, and that's pretty much it. So.
No, that makes sense. I think the one point that you said in there that I want to go back to, you made it pretty clear. You've just adapted over time to not caring. If you go back to like as a child, do you have a specific memory where you did something that everyone told you maybe wasn't a good idea or wasn't worth it and you were right and that just like lit a fire within you and you were like, oh, I don't have to listen to everybody else all the time. I can still go my own way. Do you have any moment that like sticks out?
To be honest, not really. And honestly, I don't even think I have a moment where I can say I told you so yet. I think I'm still working towards there because I've had multiple endeavors, like I told you. I've started multiple businesses that ended up failing, and I'm okay with admitting to that. But I don't think I've gotten to that point yet where I've achieved something where I could tell somebody that, yeah, I told you so. And I'm hoping that trading is going to be that, and that's what kind of drives me to the point, like that's what drives me to do
Absolutely.
better every day. Because this is actually
Cool
something
too.
that, yeah, got.
Yeah, finish. No, finish. You were
Oh,
saying
but
this is something.
this is exactly something that I actually want to be able to tell people, like, I told you so. Because a lot of people don't understand trading. When you're trading, a lot of people will look at it as like gambling, right? Like, oh, you're gambling with the markets, blah, blah, blah. But there is a systematic approach to it. And if I could perfect that, not even perfect, just get pretty good at it, then I could, tell people, like, I told you so. That's the
Exactly.
goal.
No,
The ultimate goal.
I think you also have to give credit to the fact that, and I want to circle it back to the topic of cutting out negativity, but by cutting out negativity and bouncing from thing to thing, from business to business, you might have failed on paper. The business might not have become the 6 or 7 figure or 8 figure business that you wanted it to be, but you gained a skill in that process that now when I look at you from the outside as a friend and as a business partner, I look at you and I'm like, all of those businesses that you did all prepared you to be what you are right now, to be in the position that you are right now. You can put all of that together and your knowledge of trading to increase your income more than ever. You have like open road in front of you because of those failures, but you never even would have experienced those failures had you not cut out negativity. Had you been afraid to step out on your own, you would have never experienced the failure, which would have never led to growth and learning and then this opportunity. But see, people don't get that, and I feel like it's tough. A lot of people are even afraid to fail. People are coddled, like in today's day and age, you know the joke, like the fifth place trophy kind of thing. And to me, I do think that in a way, that is a negative outlook on life because life doesn't reward you for being fifth place,
No, not at
especially
all.
right now with this virus everybody's jobs are all up in the air. You know what I mean? If you don't have control, like people like you and me, you're in fifth place and you think you should be getting rewarded, but you are not. And that definitely would be upsetting. Definitely would be a tough pill to swallow. So I feel like now more than ever, because there's even so much negativity on the outside, like, you know, we go on Twitter, we tweet our trades, and all you see is protests and riots and all this crap. It's all negative. All I do is try to talk about money and helping people make more money. And it's everything else I feel like is so negative. So you really have to block that out. Do you even pay attention to like the news and all that stuff, or you just stay off it? Just dude, imagine putting that into your brain while you're trying to trade. It's too much information.
No, man. The only time I really get updated on like current events, which is kind of a bad thing, but it's like a double-edged sword. But you're right. I like most of the time the news, they never really highlight the good things if you think about it, right? Because happy doesn't sell. Like happy does not
sell. That's it, bro. You know
negativity sells. Negativity increases ratings. That's what they want to portray. Because
people want to see other people in a bad position because they think they're in a bad position. They're not happy. A lot of people aren't happy with where they're at. So it's easy for negativity. What is the quote? Isn't it misery loves company? That's the quote.
Yeah, misery loves company. Yep,
it's
yep.
It is true as hell, man.
It's crazy. Like, yeah, they never portray it. So that's why I kind of stay away from a lot of that media stuff. I mean, the only time I ever get news is like through Instagram or like Facebook. And that's when I'm